This guide provides the basic principles of operation for the UroShield device. Please read the complete manual before using the UroShield and make sure that you understand all aspects of UroShield operation. Welcome to the UroShield application hands-on training. The UroShield is intended for use with indwelling urinary catheters and is addressing the two major problems associated with these catheters: urinary tract infections due to biofilm formation, as well as catheter-related pain, discomfort, and bladder spasms. The UroShield can be used on 14 to 22 French Foley catheters that are made of either silicone, latex, or Teflon, as well as antimicrobial and silver-coated catheters used in either urethral or suprapubic catheters. The insertion and removal of catheters should be performed only by qualified medical staff and in accordance to facility protocols and guidelines. Within the UroShield box, we have the driver, which is the electronic device that controls the therapy. We also have the UroShield clip, or the actuator, and this is actually applied to the catheter itself. This generates the surface acoustic waves. It is a single-use only accessory and is intended for a period of up to 30 days. Within the box, you will also have the adapter and the charger, as well as the user's manual and quick guide slide. An important note: the UroShield should only be installed on a newly inserted urinary catheter. It is recommended that the UroShield installation is scheduled immediately following the catheter replacement. Also note that the UroShield should not be used to resolve or treat an active urinary tract infection. So we have the urinary catheter inserted and in place, so we can start the product application. First, gently pull on the catheter till you feel slight resistance. Then we will remove the actuator from the package and untangle the wire. Then we will peel off the protective covers, remove the first tape, remove the second tape. Place the actuator on the catheter 3 to 4 centimeters from the point in which the catheter exits the body. In females, 2 fingers between the actuator and the patient. In males, 3 fingers between the actuator and the pointed patient where it exits the urethra. We want to make sure the actuator connecting cable is going towards the patient. We will carefully close the actuator that two halves snap together, making sure the catheter is not pinched or deformed in either end of the actuator. We will insert the actuator plug into the driver cable socket, making sure we orient the plug correctly in relation to the socket, and also making sure the plug is fully inserted. To switch on the UroShield on-off, press the driver's on-off button for 2 to 3 seconds. The driver will show firmware versions and perform initiation that may take about 30 seconds. While this occurs, we will connect the driver to the mains using the supply main charger. Connect the charger to the driver charging port and plug it into the main socket. The driver display shows the status of the battery on the actuator, and after 3 minutes, the display dims and shows a screensaver that will scroll on the display. Please note, when the screensaver is displayed, you can return to the battery actuator status and press on or off button briefly. The UroShield driver works intermittently in cycles of 15 minutes active, followed by 5 minutes idle. You can hear a low hum sound from the actuator during the active period. The UroShield should be active continuously, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, except when the patient is bathing or showering. So please keep it connected to the main electrical supply. For portability of the patient, the device may be disconnected from the electrical source and used in battery mode for about 6 hours. A visual blinking battery and audible beep will indicate when the battery charge drops to about a half an hour of remaining charge, and the patient should reconnect to the electrical supply at that time. Full recharge will occur about an hour and a half. For showering and bathing, the UroShield driver itself is not waterproof and should not be immersed in fluids. Before cleaning the patient, switch the UroShield off by pressing and holding the power button. Disconnect the actuator correctly by holding both cables and disconnecting the ends. Never pull from the wire. Always grab from the ends to disconnect. Leave the driver outside the bathroom. Actuator should remain attached to the catheter while the patient is showering or bathing. Following that you're bathing, dry the actuator with a towel and reconnect the driver. Pressing and turning the therapy back on. The actuator is designed for single use only. That is for use with one catheter. Each actuator will work effectively for 30 days. The actuator must be disposed of together with the catheter after removal, and a new actuator should be installed on a newly inserted catheter. Thank you.